Good evening students, welcome back to Sri Vidya Mandir Higher Secondary School. And in these videos we are going to discuss one of the 10th chapter, Plant Physiology. The topic is photosynthesis. What do you mean by photosynthesis? Where does it occur? Then what is important of photosynthesis? These are the topics we are going to discuss. Define photosynthesis. The word photo means light. Synthesis means to build or manufactures. So the term photosynthesis is literally means synthesis with the help of light. These are called photosynthesis. So where it is occurs, what are the organism it does photosynthesis? I mean autotrophic organism, all the autotrophic organisms. Autotrophs in the sense they manufacture their carbohydrates. The organism which manufacture their own food materials, those are called autotrophic organism. All autotrophic organisms, for example, all green plant, then algae, photosynthetic algae, then chlorophyll containing bacteria. For example, purple sulfur bacteria, then green sulfur bacteria. These are the photosynthetic bacteria because they contain a green color pigment is called bacteriochlorophyll pigments. So these are called photoautotrophic organism. All green plants, algae, the photoautotrophs are also bacterial chlorophyll containing bacteria, for example purple sulfur bacteria and green sulfur bacteria. They have the capacity to trap the solar energy that converted into chemical energy by this process called photosynthesis. See, all these organisms have the capacity to trap the solar energy that manufacture their own food materials. With the help of sunlight, due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment, they manufacture their own food materials. These are called autotrophic organisms. So all the autotrophic organisms manufacture their own food material through a process called photosynthesis. See, during this process, carbon dioxide combines with water to form carbohydrates such as glucose with the help of due to the presence of sunlight, then chlorophyll pigment. During this process, water molecules also released plus oxygen, the gas that evolved during photosynthesis called oxygen. So these are the overall reactions of photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, chlorophyll, these are the raw materials are needed for photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide combines with water to form carbohydrates such as glucose. During this process, oxygen is also released. It is a byproduct. Byproduct during photosynthesis. So, name the byproduct are released during photosynthesis, oxygen. So, if we balance the equations, the 6 molecule of carbon dioxide is essential for the production of 1 molecule of glucose. The next, 12 molecule of water is essential for the production of 1 molecule of glucose. Then 6 molecule of oxygen also released plus 6 molecule of water also released. So these are the overall reaction or overall equations of photosynthesis. Now where does occurs? Photosynthesis occurs in where? It occurs in all green part of the plants. For example, leaf, stem, then floral bud, young floral bud, it also contains chlorophyll pigment, they are green in color. due to the process of chloride pigment, they manufacture their own food materials. So leaf, it is an important organ for photosynthesis. So due to the presence of a green coloring pigment is called chlorophyll, it shows green in colors. Stem also perform photosynthesis. For example, Opuntia, commonly called prickly pears. The stem is become flat and thick to take up the leaf function. Usually, photosynthesis are performed by leaf. Such leaf function is performed by stem, for example, Opuntia. And the floral bud also, young floral buds also perform photosynthesis. So these are the region of plant parts photosynthesis occurs. The next heading, photosynthetic pigments. Right. What is called photosynthetic pigments? Then what are the pigments that are involved in the photosynthesis? It is also called biosynthetic phase. The pigments that are involved in the photosynthesis, these are called photosynthetic pigments. Generally, they are grouped or classified into two classes. One is primary pigment. Primary pigment. Then second one is secondary pigment. Secondary pigment, it is also called accessory pigment. So these are called photosynthetic pigments. So once again, I would remember what is called photosynthetic pigment. The pigment that are involved in the photosynthesis are called photosynthetic pigment. For example, primary pigment and secondary pigment. These are the two groups of pigment. What are called primary pigments? Chlorophyll A. These are called primary pigments. It is also called universal pigments. Universal pigments. Because they universally present in all green part of the plants. That is why we call it is a universal pigment. It is also called a primary pigment. Then it is a mainly involved in the absorption of solar energy for photosynthesis. So that is why it is called as a universal pigment or also called a primary pigment. Remember, why do we call it? Why do we call chlorophyll A as called a primary pigment? Because it is directly involved in the photosynthesis. They trap the solar energy converted into chemical energy. So that is act as a reaction center. Reaction center. Chlorophyll A is a reaction center. Also primary pigment is also called as a reaction center. Then what is called accessory pigment or also called secondary pigment? Other than photosynthetic pigment, other than the chlorophyll A are called accessory pigment or also called secondary pigment. For example, chlorophyll B, carotenoid, xanthophyll, then phycoblemes. So these are called accessory pigment or also called secondary pigment. Then what are the functions of these accessory pigments? To trap, it pass the absorbed solar energy into the chlorophyll A. So these are called harvesting centers. Harvesting center. Then what is called reaction center and harvesting center? The photosynthetic pigments, all the photosynthetic pigments, they are aggregated to perform a photosynthetic activities. These are called reaction centers. So here, the chlorophyll A, it is a reaction center. Reaction centers. So what are the main functions of this chlorophyll A? They are mainly involved in the absorption of photon of light energy. Photon of light energy. So the light energy is absorbed or captured by the chlorophyll A. Then what are the functions of these? It is a functions of chlorophyll A, or also called primary pigment. What are the functions of this secondary pigment? It pass the absorbed light energy to the chlorophyll A by accessory pigment. So as a result, the chlorophyll A molecule gets excited or elevated to emit a energized electrons. Two pair of electrons are gets emit or released. So chlorophyll A, it is a reaction center. This accessory pigment is called as a harvesting center. It's nothing but light harvesting center, LHC. Why do we call it is a light harvesting center? It transfer, it pass the absorbed light energy into the reaction center, also chlorophyll A. Now the chlorophyll molecule gets excited or elevated, the photosynthesis reactions are takes place. So these are the major differences between the primary pigment and accessory pigment. Primary pigment, it is a chlorophyll A. Other than the chlorophyll A are called accessory pigments. The next, what are the role of sunlight in photosynthesis? Next topic, role of sunlight in photosynthesis. We know that sunlight, it is one of the raw materials needed for photosynthesis. Likewise, carbon dioxide, water molecule, chlorophyll pigment. Likewise, sunlight, it is one of the raw materials are needed for photosynthesis. So what is the role of sunlight in during photosynthesis? See, the entire process of photosynthesis takes place within the a green coloring plastids is called chloroplast. The chloroplast which contain a green coloring pigment is called chlorophyll is present. So chlorophyll, it's mainly involved in the photosynthesis. So the entire process of photosynthesis takes place within the a green coloring plastids is called chloroplast. Chloroplast, it is one of the cell organelles that present only in the green plant. So it was absent in the animal cell. Only plant cells, only chloroplast is present. It generally, chloroplast, it can be measured. There may be 2 to 10 micrometer in diameters. So the breadth or width of the chloroplast is minimum to maximum 10 micrometers in diameters. The thickness 1 to 2 micrometers in thickness. It is present only in the plant cells. So the entire or total process, it includes two groups. One is light reaction and dark reaction. So before we are going to discuss the light reaction, dark reaction, it is essential we should know the structure of chloroplast. The chloroplast, generally it is oval in shape. Or disc shape, like structure or discoid shape. It is enveloped by double membrane like structures. In iron plants, generally it is a disc shape like structure or oval in shape. It is enveloped by two membranes. One is outer membrane. Then inner membrane. The space present in between the outer and the inner membrane, these are called intermembrane space. It's two membranes. And next, the inner membrane, which is enclosed with a matrix, is called stroma. So these are called stroma. inner membrane enclosed with or filled with a matrix substance called stroma. In the stroma, there are many grana are embedded. It is a grana. So this total structure is called granum. Singular granum. Granum, 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 granum. Totally we call it as a grana. So in higher plants actually each chloroplast composed of 40 to 60 grana are present. Each granum is made up of a disc shaped lamellae. Yes. That's all. Each granum is made up of a disc shaped lamellae is called thylakoids. So this structure is called thylakoids. The thylakoids are enclosed by the membrane which encloses space is called lumen. These are called lumen of thylakoids, which contain chlorophyll pigment or the photosynthetic pigment which is located in the lumen of the thylakoids. So what are the pigments that are involved in the photosynthesis? Those pigments are which is located in the lumen of the thylakoids. If the thylakoids are arranged one above another, or it look like a stack of coins, are also called pile of coins, is called granum. So don't get confused. Granum is made up of thylakoids. What is called thylakoids? It's a single granular membrane. A single lamellar membrane or Yes. A single granular membrane is called thylakoids. Thylakoids contain photosynthetic pigments, which is located in a space is called lumen of the space or lumen of thylakoids. Lumen is which is enclosed by membrane is called thylakoid membrane. If the thylakoids arranged one above another look like a pile of coins, or also called stack of coins, like 1 rupee coins arranged one above another, this whole structure is called granum. Now each granum which is interconnected by the membrane is called front channel. Each granum interconnected to a membrane is called front channel. These are called front channel or also called front membrane. Front membrane. So these thylakoids contain chlorophyll pigments. The stroma contain a small circular DNA. It is a circular DNA and also RNA. It is essential for protein synthesis. Also contain a lot of other molecules which is essential for protein synthesis. And ribosomes also present. Ribosome, it is one of the membraneless cell organelles present. Due to the presence of ribosomes, they are mainly involved in the protein synthesis. So stroma, it is a matrix substance which contains circular DNA, RNA and ribosomes, certain other molecules which is essential for protein synthesis. Those are present in the stroma. Enzymes, it contains a lot of enzymes for photosynthesis. Those enzymes also present in the stroma. Then pigments only present in the thylakoid membrane are also called stroma. Sorry, granum. Now, the overall total process of photosynthesis includes two processes. total process of photosynthesis or overall reactions of photosynthesis, it includes two steps. The first step is called light reactions. What is light reactions? Another one is dark reactions. So this light reaction, it is also called light dependent reactions. Light dependent reactions, because light is essential for this process. So that is why we call it a light dependent reaction, or also called light reactions. It is also called Hill reactions. Hill reactions, because it was first demonstrated by Hill in the year 1939. So the total process of photosynthesis includes two groups. One is a light reaction, another one is a dark reactions. Dark reaction, it is also called light independent reactions. Independent reaction, because light is not essential for photosynthesis, though so they are called dark reactions. It was first demonstrated by Melvin Galvin. Melvin Galvin. So they are called Galvin cycle. It is also called C3 cycle, because the first stable product, a 3-carbon compound, is called PGA, phosphoglyceric is formed. Due to the formation of first stable product, a 3-carbon compound is called phosphoglyceric acid, so they are called C3 cycle. You are going to study detail in higher classes. Now it's not essential. So what are the reactions between light and dark action? It is first demonstrated by Hill, so they are called Hill reaction in the year 1939. It was first demonstrated by Melvin Galvin, so they are called Galvin cycles, are also called C3 cycles. The second steps, the photosynthetic pigments, I mean these light reactions, are takes place in the presence of light. Presence of light, which converted into, absorb the light energy, converted into chemical energy. Solar energy is converted into chemical energy in the form of ATP and NADPH2. So these are the end product of light reactions. The pigment which is present in the chloroplast to trap the solar energy, or capturing the solar energy, which is converted into chemical energy in the form of ATP and NADPH2. ATP is nothing but adenosine triphosphate. NADPH2 is nothing but nicotinamide, adenine dinucleotide, hydrogen phosphate. So these are the end product of light reactions. So what is called dark reaction? In this reaction, carbon dioxide is reduced into carbohydrate with the help of this ATP and NADPH2, which are generated by the light reactions. Here, carbon dioxide is reduced to carbohydrate, CH2O6N. These are the molecular formula for carbohydrate. Reduction in the sense addition of hydrogen and removal of oxygen. So carbon dioxide, we know that carbon dioxide is one of the raw materials needed for photosynthesis. Then what is called dark action? Reduction of carbon dioxide into carbohydrate. Reduction in the sense addition of hydrogens. With the help of ATP and NADPH2, which are generated by light reactions. I mean, without light reaction, there is no dark reactions that takes place. Because if the dark reactions essential for the reduction of one molecule of carbon dioxide into carbohydrate, they require ATP. I mean, how many ATP? 3 ATP and 2 NADPH2 are required for the reduction of one molecule of carbon dioxide into carbohydrate. Such ATP and NADPH2 are synthesized by light reactions. So these are the end product. Remember, what are the end product of dark reaction? Carbohydrate. What are the end product of light reaction? ATP and NADPH2. Another one important, these light reactions are takes place in thylakoid membrane are also granum of chloroplast. Dark reaction takes place in stroma of the living chloroplast. So for this purpose, just I draw the diagram here. Overall process of photosynthesis are inputs two reactions. One is a light reaction, another one is a dark reaction. These two reactions are takes place different site in the chloroplast. Remember, both reactions are takes place within the chloroplast, but in different site, different places. In question, light reaction takes place in the total structure of granum, or also called thylakoid. Remember, because the photosynthetic pigments are located in the granum or thylakoids. But whereas in dark reaction takes place in the stroma. Dark reaction, here light reactions, but it is at different places. Synthesis of ATP and NADPH2 by light reaction in the thylakoid membrane, they diffuse out into the stroma. Because dark reaction takes place in the stroma, they utilize ATP and NADPH2 synthesized by light reactions in the chloroplast, or also means granules. So it's a major difference between light reaction and dark reaction. Now, it is easy or better to understand. I will draw the schematic representations. For better, easy to understand the light reaction, dark reactions, where it takes place within the chloroplast, I will draw the schematic representations. Yes. It is a chloroplast structures. It is a two membrane, outer and the inner membrane. The space between the two membrane is called intermembrane space. Overall reaction of photosynthesis. It is a chloroplast. It is a stroma. It is a thylakoids. So the pigment thylakoids light reaction takes place here. Light reaction, or also called the Hill reactions. Here it is a dark reaction. Are also called as Calvin cycle. Yes. Due to the process of the pigments, the photosynthetic pigments which is located in the thylakoid or grana, which capture the light energy, which is converted into chemical energy in the form of ATP and NADPH2. Here, ADP gets reduced into ATP. NADP plus reducer into NADPH2. So these are oxidized state. Oxidation, oxidized state is nothing but a loss of electrons and also hydrogens. These are oxidized state. These are the reduction state. Reduction state is nothing but a gain of electrons and hydrogens. The pigment which is present in the thylakoid membrane trap the solar energy which is converted into chemical energy in the form of ATP and NADPH2. These are the end product of light reaction, we know that. Now how the ATP and NADPH are synthesized? With the help of ADP, adenosine diphosphate, it is an oxidized state, gets reduced into ATP. Reduction in the sense addition of hydrogens. ADP is reduced into ATP. And another one oxidized state of NADP plus nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate gets addition of hydrogen reduced into NADPH2. These are called light reactions. During this process, it utilizes water molecules. So water, it is one of the raw materials needed for photosynthesis. The water is utilized to release oxygen. Oxygen is a byproduct. We know that byproduct. So now the oxygen released during photosynthesis actually comes from where? Water molecules. It's a light reaction. What's called dark reaction? Reduction of carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide is obtained from where? Atmosphere. Reduction of carbon dioxide into carbohydrates such as glucose. The glucose, it is a 6 carbon compound. 6 carbon compound. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon compound. So these are the end product of dark reaction. Carbon dioxide is reduced into carbohydrates such as glucose or starch with the help of ATP. With the help of ATP and NADPH2. So ATP and NADPH2 are synthesized by light reaction, utilized by dark reaction for the reduction of one molecule of carbon dioxide. So now the ATP, which lost the electron captured by dark reaction to form again come back into the oxidized state, ADP. ATP lost electron and hydrogen to form ADP diphosphate. Similarly, NADPH2 lost electrons and also hydrogen again come back to the original state that is called oxidized state. So these are the overall scheme of photosynthesis, light reaction and dark reactions. Next, what are the factors that affect the rate of photosynthesis? Factors affecting photosynthesis. There are two types of factors are essential for photosynthesis. One is internal factors. Factors, then external factors. The factor affecting photosynthesis. These are the factor essential for photosynthesis. At the same time, those factor which is not available to the plant, automatically they affect the rate of photosynthesis. That is why these are the factors affecting photosynthesis. It is grouped into internal factors. Internal factors, for example, pigment, photosynthetic pigments. Next, leaf age. Then third one is accumulation of carbohydrate. Then fourth one is hormones. So these are the internal factors essential for photosynthesis. At the same time, these are the factors which affect the rate of photosynthesis when it's not available to the plant. External factors are grouped into sunlight, carbon dioxide, water, temperature, then minerals. So these are the external factors that is essential for photosynthesis. Then first one is internal factors, pigments. So the pigments are grouped two categories. One is a primary pigment, secondary pigment. Chlorophyll A is a primary pigment. Other than chlorophyll A is called tertiary pigment, secondary pigment. Those pigments are involved in the photosynthesis. If there is any reduction in the supply of pigments to the photosynthesis to the plant, automatically rate of photosynthesis also affected. So pigment is essential. If suppose due to various factors the pigment is the number of pigments are less, the rate of photosynthesis are affected. Leaf age, how the leaf age affect the rate of photosynthesis? See, the leaf generally is a green in color due to the presence of chlorophyll pigment. In aged leaf or old leaf, it lost the chlorophyll as a result to form and it similar, gradually turn into yellow color. These are called yellow color patches. In older leaves, due to the loss of chlorophyll pigment, it turned into yellow color and ultimately the leaves are shed from the plant. So, leaf is an important photosynthetic organ. If the leaf is filled out, what will happen? The rate of photosynthesis is affected, especially which leaves, older leaves are also called leaf age. This process called senescence process also there. Our next, accumulation of carbohydrate. Where the carbohydrate synthesis is, leaf it is an important region for the synthesis of or storage of carbohydrate. If all the synthesized carbohydrate, they get translocated to the other part for their storage. If it does not take place, translocation does not take place from where to where, leaves to the other part, for example, root, stem, these are the storage organ. Where is the synthesis organ? Leaf is a synthesis organ. Where is the storage organ? Root, stem is a storage organ. So, the food manufacture part leaf, they translocate the food or carbohydrate to the other part. If translocation does not take place, what will happen? The synthesis of carbohydrates are accumulated in the leaf. Automatically, it will reduce the rate of photosynthesis. So, accumulation of carbohydrates is also one of the factors affect the rate of photosynthesis. Hormone. There are five groups of hormones are present. Auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin, ethylene, ABA. Among these, the ABA is nothing but abscisic acid. These are the negative role which make closed off stomata. What are the important effect of ABA? It causes closed off stomata. If the stomata gets closed, what will happen? Gaseous exchange does not take place. So the atmospheric carbon dioxide enter into the leaf through a minute opening, it's called stomata. If the stomata gets closed, carbon dioxide will not enter into the leaf, automatically the photosynthesis get arrested. So this plant hormone APA abscisic acid, it is an important role for affect the rate of photosynthesis. They cause closed off stomata. So these are the internal factors. Then next, what are the external factors? Sunlight, we know that where the source of sunlight is solar system. Sunlight gets converted to chemical energy. Solar energy gets converted to chemical energy in the form of ATP and NADPH2. If the due to cloudy season, the rate of photosynthesis gets reduced. So it's a factors. Carbon dioxide, there is any reduction of carbon dioxide, there is any reduction in the supply of carbon dioxide to the plant, automatically the rate of photosynthesis is affected. Water, it is an electron donor, essential. If any reduction in the supply of water to the plant, automatically the rate of photosynthesis also gets arrested. Temperature is important factors. How? At a higher temperature and low temperature also, the rate of photosynthesis gets arrested. Because the stroma contain lot of enzymes. Those enzymes are involved in the photosynthesis. So, those enzymes, it gets inactivated at higher temperature. and also inactivated at low temperature also. So both higher temperature and low temperature, the photosynthesis gets arrested. The next, minerals. How the minerals are play an important role in the photosynthesis? For example, magnesium. Magnesium, it is essential for the formation of chlorophyll molecules. Similarly, manganese, Mn, it is also essential for the photolysis of waters. For example, calcium ion, magnesium ion. So these are essential for the photolysis of water during photosynthesis. So if there is any reduction in the supply of minerals, especially magnesium, also called magnesium, calcium, automatically the rate of photosynthesis gets arrested. So these are the factors that is essential for photosynthesis. Thank you, students. And you watch my videos without skipping. You may easily understand. And in the next videos, we are going to discuss the continuous topic.